కోవిడ్ ప్రభావం నుంచి వేగంగా కోలుకునే విధంగా టీకా సామర్థ్యాన్ని పెంచేందుకు యుఎస్ ఇంటర్నేషనల్ డెవలప్మెంట్ ఫైనాన్స్ కార్పొరేషన్ డిఎఫ్సితో రుణ ఒప్పందాన్ని కుదుర్చుకుంది బయలాజికల్ ఈ లిమిటెడ్. భారత్లో కోవిడ్ వ్యాక్సిన్ మ్యానుఫ్యాక్చరింగ్ సదుపాయాలను పెంచేందుకు 5 కోట్ల డాలర్ల విలువైన రుణ సదుపాయాన్ని బయలాజికల్ ఈ లిమిటెడ్కు అందిస్తున్నట్లు ఈ సందర్భంగా ప్రకటించింది యుఎస్ ఇంటర్నేషనల్ డెవలప్మెంట్ ఫైనాన్స్ కార్పొరేషన్. ఇందుకు సంబంధించిన ఒప్పంద పత్రాలపై డిఎఫ్సి చీఫ్ ఆపరేటింగ్ ఆఫీసర్ డేవిడ్ మార్చిక్, బయలాజికల్ ఈ మేనేజింగ్ డైరెక్టర్ మహిమా దాట్లలు సంతకాలు చేశారు.
Since the start of the Biden administration, the DFC has been looking to partner with vaccine manufacturers around the world. And today, we've already supported 3 companies, one in India, BioE, and 2 in Africa. And combined, they're going to produce over 2 billion doses of vaccines between now and the end of the next year. That represents about 18% of the global need of the 11 billion that I mentioned. And this is a remarkable effort that will not only bring benefits to India, but as Mahima said, also to the world. And it's an example of how the Quad, and also the US and India working together, can not only solve problems in India, but more importantly, the US and India can solve global problems.
Even as we speak, we are submitting doses to Kasoli for release. So it is my hope that we will, at the day of launch, it's always been our vision to supply close to 10 crore doses on the day, and that's going to happen end of November. So as soon as we get the license, we'll look. That's in early stages, so I can't disclose too many details about it. But the mRNA vaccine is a technology platform, not just for COVID vaccines, but it's very strategic for us to be able to look at other infectious diseases and immunotherapeutics. Actually, it doesn't distinguish, but the idea really for it to come in the Quad initiative is for it to act as support for the countries that need the vaccine more, both in the Indo-Pacific region, but also in the rest of the world. So it doesn't differentiate, or it's not earmarked specifically for exports. It's intended as a general expansion, which will serve both the needs of our country as well as others.